Alright, I'm running out of fucking family members, but this is your boy Chad here. Today we're having an OU tier match against Seb Gandy from Discord. If you guys like to battle me, hit me up on Twitter, Facebook, or Discord. Links, as always, are in the description below. So Seb wanted a rematch after our previous battle this week, and we decided to rematch with different teams. So I got this team from Pokegaim. He was in the middle of doing his Mamoswine to the top series, so this team caught my eye. It looked pretty interesting. But looking at my opponent's team, he's got the Lopunny, which is obviously a mega. And scary as hell. He also has the Tapu Bulu, the Greninja, the Kumo-o, Gengar, and the Tapu Koko. While looking at my team, we've got the Magearna, Tapu Koko of my own, a Garchomp, a Mamoswine of course, the Celesteela, and the Mantine. So, pretty fun battle, guys. I hope you'll enjoy. So the battle begins. I'm going to lead off with my Magearna, as my opponent is going to lead off with Jessrabbit, the Mega Lopunny here. So this is actually not bad for me. I'm actually a Choice Scarf Magearna this time around, which I do outspeed her, or him rather. I forgot he's a guy, but he plays as a girl. Anyway, my opponent's going to Mega Evolve and just go for the Fake Out, as all Mega Lopunny do. And yeah, it would have been nice had my opponent gone for something else, thinking that he was faster, but he's actually not. So he's going to flinch me on the first turn. And my opponent is not an idiot, so he actually swaps out into Gandygar, which is his Gengar. As I go for the Floor Cannon, even though it's resisted, Gengar is like paper-thin frail. It's still going to take a dick load of damage here. And because of the special attack drop, and because of his cursed body, I'm going to have to get the hell out of here. it would have been funny, though. I would have had to basically hit this thing with Struggle. But yeah, I'm going to get the hell out of here. I'm going to go into Pinhead Larry here, which is my Celesteela. My opponent is going to go for the Shadow Ball here. It actually crits me, which really sucks, because now that's going to really hurt Celesteela's like staying power here. So, and my opponent also has the Thunderbolt, which also hurts. I actually managed to live that as well. And I'm just going to go for the Heavy Slam here to kill off Gandygar. And unfortunately, Celesteela is a hurting puppy here. Not going to stick around too much longer. Oddly enough, my opponent's cursed body is going to activate yet again. And yeah, so I'm going to get basically a useless beast boost here. I don't plan on keeping Celesteela around much any longer, so. Here, my opponent is going to go out into the Kumo-o. Now, I kind of figured my opponent would probably try to set up with its exclusive Z move or whatever, the Kumonium Z or whatever, and get the plus one and boost to all stats. So I'm gonna actually bring out my Magearna here as my opponent. That is exactly what my opponent goes for. And because I'm a fairy type, it actually doesn't work on me. So my opponent was so mad. He was like typing in the chat, like, fuck you, Chad, when I did this. It was so funny. So his Z move is not gonna work, and he doesn't get the plus one boost to all stats, I don't think. And wow, I just realized in the background of the battle, there's actually fucking, what's that mon called? The little meteor guy, Minior or whatever? There's little Minior like flying across the screen. I don't know if you guys noticed that. But anyway, I'm gonna bring out my Garchomp here as my opponent is going to Sky Uppercut me, and he's gonna take some Rocky Helmet and some Rough Skin damage. That's actually gonna do a dick load of damage. I'm actually able to set up some free Stealth Cocks here as my opponent is going to go for the Clanging Scales. Obviously, it's a special attack, it doesn't make contact. And so that was a good play on his part. And here, I'm just going to go for the Poison Jab on the off chance he wanted to bring in his Bulu. But he doesn't. He actually stays in here, just goes for another Clanging Scales. And that is going to kill off my Garchomp. But it's all good. Garchomp did a fantastic job getting the chip damage off on this Kumo-o, as well as getting some Stealth Cocks up. So I just love all the Minior's like flying across the screen. It's kind of fucking adorable. So here, I'm just going to bring out my my Magearna once again, and honestly, Magearna, like, shits all over this man's team. Like, Magearna is such a problem for this man's team. And I'm just going to go for the Ice Beam, kill off Kumo-o. I get the Soul Heart, plus one special attack boost, but my opponent is now going to bring out the Tapu Koko, and I kind of don't want to fuck with this thing, especially since this is not my AV Magearna. So I'm actually going to go ahead and get the hell out of here, because I actually calced it. Ice Beam at plus one does not kill this thing, so. Here, I'm going to bring out the Mamoswine as my opponent is going to go for the Nature's Madness. I was kind of bummed that he didn't go for like an electric attack. Would have been nice, but it's all good. What can you do? So he's actually going to U-turn out. I was actually, this part of the battle was kind of a dumb play, but also I just wanted to do it for the lulz. So I actually have Z-Hail on this Mamoswine, And what it does is it gives you a plus one boost to speed, and it obviously sets up hail as well. So that's what I'm going for, as I think he brought in his Lopunny. I was praying he didn't bring in Lopunny. Had he not brought in Lopunny, Mamoswine probably could have done some work here, but them's the breaks. The hail's gonna get set up. He's gonna get hit by hail. I'm an ice type, so I'm good. But here he's gonna go for the fake out, and oddly enough, I actually live on fucking 1 HP. That is fucking wild. And I'm just gonna go for the earthquake here. It's going to do a dickload of damage, but unfortunately for me, my opponent's gonna live on a sliver of health and be able to kill me off with a drain punch here. So unfortunately for me, Z-Hail Mamoswine didn't really get to shine this battle. It sucks, but it's whatever, it happens. As I said before, had he not gone into the Mega Lopunny, Mamoswine definitely could have shined a little bit. But anyway, I'm gonna bring out my Magearna now, because I definitely outspeed this thing. I'm just gonna go for a Volt Switch. It's obviously gonna kill this thing as he stays in here. And I'm gonna get the Soul Heart. Like, I think it's dumb that if you kill something with Volt Switch, you still get the Soul Heart. Like, that just wastes time. You're not even gonna use it because you have to swap out. But anyway, it's whatever. So here, I'm gonna bring out my Tapu Koko. Oddly enough, on the turn that the electric terrain goes away. But it wouldn't have mattered because he's actually going to bring out his Bulu now. And so he's gonna set up the grassy terrain here. And I'm just gonna swap out because I don't really wanna fuck with this thing. I'm just going to sack off my Celesteela now, as my opponent is going to go for the Wood Hammer. I love that animation. It's so fucking clean. I love the gigantic hammer. It's so funny. But anyway, he's gonna kill me off with that. He's gonna take some recoil damage from that. I'm gonna bring out my Magearna here and basically just go for Ice Beam as he, oddly enough, stays in. I wasn't expecting him to actually stay in there, but anyway, he's gonna go for the superpower here and actually take that pretty damn well, all things considered. Usually Bulu has a pretty monstrous attack stat, but anyway, we take that, and I'm just gonna go for another Ice Beam, basically trying to kill this thing, but he doesn't want to let his Bulu go down just yet. He's actually gonna bring out the Greninja here, which is a good play by him. So I don't know if this is going to be like a Battle Bond Greninja or if it's going to be a Protean Greninja, but we are about to find out in one moment here. So I'm gonna swap out because obviously Ice Beam is not doing much damage to this thing. I'm gonna bring out my boy Steve Irwin here, RIP. And he's gonna go for the HP Fire here. Obviously that's not gonna do dick for damage here, so it's like resisted and shit, plus Mantine has monstrous special defense, so it's kind of weird seeing a Mantine in OU, but I fuck with it. So here I'm just gonna go for the I swap out. Never mind, I bring in Magearna again, I guess. And he's gonna go for the Gunk Shot. As we see, he is the Protean Greninja, and it doesn't affect me being a Steel type. So that's like the second time this battle that Magearna's come in basically for free. And yeah, so here I'm just gonna go for the Volt Switch, as I thought my opponent would stay, or I thought my opponent would swap out here, but he, for whatever reason, like, he never switches when I think he's gonna switch. But anyway, he's gonna go for the Hidden Power here, and once again, Steve Irwin's gonna come in here and eat those. So I believe here I just go for the Scald, basically just trying to get damage off. I think that's what I do. No, okay, he swaps out. He goes out into his Tapu Koko. Yeah, I think I still go for Scald, though. And Scald's gonna do a decent amount of chip damage off on this Tapu Koko, because Tapu Koko is actually fairly frail on the special side, usually, so. And I actually managed to snag a burn there, which, if this Tapu Koko was physical, it definitely would have helped. But I believe his is special, so I'm gonna go ahead and swap out because I don't want to take an electric terrain, electric attack on a quad weak mon. So I'm gonna actually bring out my own Tapu Koko, and my own Tapu Koko can basically clean up at this point. So he's actually going to die to his burn. I believe he only has like one or two mons left. Let's see. All right, so he's got his Bulu, and I can basically kill this thing off. I do have the HP Fire on my Tapu Koko, or actually no, I think this one's HP Ice. Yeah, I believe this one's actually HP Ice. I have another battle where I used an HP Fire Tapu Koko. But yeah, this one's Ice, and that's going to kill off the Bulu. And I believe he only has this one mon left, which is his Greninja. And I guess he doesn't have the Water Shuriken, or if he does, he didn't go for it for some reason. So I'm actually going to outspeed him, go for the T-Bolt, and that is game. So good game, Seb Gandhi. We will definitely rematch again, and yeah, if you guys enjoyed the battle, leave a like. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Discord. Links as always are in the description below. I love you guys. Peace out.